After installing the VectorScribe plugin, you need to open the Dynamic Corners panel by first going to Window, VectorScribe, Dynamic Corners panel. Clicking on that will open the panel as can be seen here. To introduce the tool, we'll first examine the suitcase within this artwork by zooming into this area, and we can see immediately that this right angle here should actually be applied with a curved corner. This is an ideal task for the Dynamic Corners tool, as paths such as this with corner points, and that can be corner points between straight lines and straight lines and Bezier curves, etc., so long as they're not already smooth points, can have dynamic corners applied. So to do so on this example, I'm going to switch to the Dynamic Corners tool. You can do this either by clicking on the icon in the toolbox or by clicking on the newly opened Dynamic Corners panel. Having done so, you can see that there are minimal options, but the power of the Dynamic Corners tool is quite deep, and we recommend that you watch all the videos associated with this tool to get the most out of it. So to apply a dynamic corner to this right angle, you can see if I hover over the corner point, an annotation of the radius is displayed. I can then either click on the corner point, or if I undo that, click and drag, so I can resize at the same time. As it's dynamic, I'm able to change this radius by dragging at any stage, or entering the value in the Dynamic Corners panel. I can also modify the corner point by holding down the Alt key and dragging it around like so. And the dynamic nature will remain for as long as possible. Having looked at that corner, we'll zoom back out again and examine another part of the artwork for which dynamic corners can be applied. In this case, we'll be looking at this rectangle here, representing another suitcase, which we will select with the standard select tool. Just click on the rectangle. And by doing so, you are effectively selecting all the points in the shape. Once these points are selected, they can also be turned into corners by clicking on the Dynamic Corners tool and clicking Apply to Selection in the panel. This automatically applies the dynamic corners to all selected points on a path. I can modify the radius of these corners simultaneously. We'll go back and look at another portion of this artwork and see a case where a dynamic corner can be applied to a live effect. If I select this roof structure shape here, the roof structure has a live effect applied which replicates the artwork many times. I'm now going to apply rounded corners to this corner and this corner. And I'm going to use another technique on this occasion by first switching over to the Dynamic Corners tool and then holding down the Alt key and dragging a marquee box over the two points I want to change into rounded corners. Note that the upper point in this marquee box will have no effect with a rounded corner because it's already a smooth point. So when releasing the mouse, I can see that the two rounded corners have been applied. There are two methods in which rounded corners are created. The default method is a true radius, which you can see here is a perfect portion of a circle. The alternative method is Adobe's method of rounding corners, which we call standard. And this can have benefits in certain circumstances, such as this example here, whereas if we switch to a standard rounded corner, it is actually more visually appealing for this particular artwork. So if I switch between the true rounded corners and the standard rounded corners, you can see the change.